Hi everybody, this is Reza with Profile Traders, and we are looking at the chart of ES September the 4th. I'm gonna go ahead and start with what was taking place yesterday. We can see that down there for several sessions the sellers were trying very hard to break the price to the downside in order to come and fill a gap that is sitting around the 2883 level, where you also have a naked POC hanging there from this session here. But the result is every time that they tried, they failed and price returned back towards the middle of the distribution that was taking place. The fact that every time down there we were going rotational was a clear signal that the sellers were weakening. Then came last night. Last night we tested the value area of the previous day session at 2907 and we rejected it to the downside. And that is why I tweeted, if we do break below 2905, we should then come and test the lower value area at around 2898.5 or 98. But once it did reject the value area, as you can see, we saw absolutely no follow through to the downside, but rather again we went completely rotational with no follow through down. Then something very important happened. G period of last night broke price to the upside, and by doing so we did two things. One, we exited the developing rotation that took place where everybody was piling into shorts. Two, we also exited the upper boundary of the previous day session's rotation. And three, the run on the upside was very directional with momentum, and there was absolutely no question that the move on the upside was a serious one. That is why I went long and I told you this move should last all the way towards 2930, which it did. Then came the overnight session ended and we had a target 2930 met. We went rotational up there. But the entire overnight was a very strong, solid structure. If it wasn't strong or solid, we would have not have rejected this much below. We would have come down and retraced some of it during the overnight, which we didn't. Therefore, the structure of the overnight was a very clear indication that the victory was in hand of the buyers. So we had then to locate a zone in order to buy into the initial weakness of the morning. Clearly there were two numbers, 2922, which was the start of where these minus developments end were, and then 2919. I was fishing for 2919 and I missed my entry, but the 2922 stopped the move. So the moral of the story is, when the overnight structure is very strong, the initial pullback that you see, where everybody was sending me all sorts of tweets that I was an idiot follow trender, that the move of overnight was going to be reversed entirely, all sorts of things. You cannot get fooled by thinking that the initial weakness off of the open retracing some of the overnight strength, that is a signal that the whole entire overnight is reversing. Oftentimes when the structure is this strong, the initial weakness that you get is actually a buying opportunity, and that is a situation that they create in order to find advantageous entries for themselves to pile in and buy it. and I was absolutely right. 29.22 to 29.19 was the area to buy, and the target on the upside was 29.40. Now we are at a very important point. If the 29.40 to 29.47 is cleared, there is a naked POC up there at 29.61.5, which we should be going and getting. You have to understand that these colossal moves to the downside, when they do happen, they are based on news. And we had several situations that were waiting on the market. You had the situation with the trade war. You had the situation with the fact that many of the currencies were crashing against the dollar. You had the unrest with Hong Kong. So now the trade war is looking better since the Chinese said they are willing to talk. You had a rally in other currencies against the dollar. The situation in Hong Kong is a little bit better. So the focus of the market now moving forward is going to be one and one thing only. What will the Federal Reserve do in regards to the with their interest rates? And I can assure you one thing, any substantial pullback that will happen before the Fed meeting, they will buy into it. No serious money, no big money is going to risk to be short going into a Federal Reserve meeting when there is a chance of a half a point rate cut. So I will continue to buy into the weakness until proven otherwise. Have a wonderful evening and see you next time.